The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 7th chapter, text number 5, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on August 11th, 1974, in Vrindavan, India.
Pariyam itastu anyan pratiteng vidhi me para jivahutan mahabaho jaya idam sagati jagat. So, Krishna has explained this material world, bhumi rāpana lovāra. Now, this is also nature, prakriti. There is another nature, prakriti. Prakriti means Sthilinga, omen. Jiva Bhuta, the living entities, are not mentioned in this connection as Purusha, not Purusha. The Mayavadi philosophers, they think themselves as Purusha. The Kurmis also, they think they are Purusha. Purusha means Enjoyer, and Prakriti means Enjoyer. But Krishna does not say that the living entity is Purusha. He says Prakriti. Prakriti is always subordinate to the Purusha. That is the natural way. In the Manusamrita, it is said the Prakriti or Stri never deserve to be independent. Satantatam arhati. So as soon as the living entity is accepted as Prakriti, then it is to be understood that she is under the control of the Supreme Purusha, Purushottam. Krishna is Purushottam. And Krishna has been accepted as the Purusha by Arjuna. Param Brahma, Param Dhamma, Pavitram, Paramam Bhavan, Purusham Sashvatam. It is not that Krishna has become Purusha now, and before that he was impersonal. No, Krishna is Purusha Sashvatam. Eternally he is Purusha. Eternally he is Enjoyer. He is never enjoyed. You cannot enjoy Krishna or God for your sense gratification. That is not possible. He can use you for his sense gratification. That is bhakti māra. The bhaktas, they never claim to be purusha. They are always subordinate. Mama janmani janmani ishkare bhavata bhakti rahi tuki tai. This is bhakti yoga. So, this material energy is inferior, and the spiritual energy, although prakriti, still it is superior. That is explained. Why superior? Because the spiritual energy, prakriti, can control over the material energy. There is some tinge of purusha activities, but actually living entity is not Purusha, it's Prakriti. Whereas the material energy, bhumi rapa anaro vayu, is controlled by the Supreme, controlled as Krishna. Similarly, we are also controlled by the Supreme controller as Krishna. And because Krishna is controller both of the material energy and the spiritual energy, he is called the Supreme controller. Ishvara Parama Krishna, Satchidananda Vidya. In another place, Krishna says, so far the material energy is concerned, he says, Maya Dhakshena Prakriti Shivatesa Characharam. Maya Dhakshena, under my superintendence, this material energy is working. In another place, in the Brahma Samhita, it is said, Srishti Sthiti Pralayasa Dhanasakti Rita Chaiva Jasya Bhuvanani Divati Durga. Durga Shakti, or external energy. Durga. Durga means the superintendent of the four. Durga. Durga means four. Where you cannot get out or cannot enter very easily. That is called Durga. Durga Mata. So, Durga means the superintendent deity of this material world. So she is very powerful, Durga. How much powerful? Srishti Sthiti Pralaya Sadhana Shakti. She can create, she can maintain, and she can destroy the whole material energy, whole material cosmic manifestation. It's so powerful. Sisti Sthiti Pralaya Sadhana Shakti Rita Chaiva. Still she is working, not independently. Chaiva, just like chaya or reflection or shadow, not independently. The material scientist who thinks that the material energy is working independently, they are mistaken. Material energy cannot work independently. We have got experience. However, gorgeous machine may be, unless there is touch of the spirit soul, the machine cannot work. Similarly, the big machine, cosmic manifestation, everything is going on very nicely. But it is being worked out by the plan of Krishna. That is stated by Krishna himself, Maya Dhakshena Prakriti Shivate Sacharacharam. And similarly, it is confirmed by Brahma, Srishti Sthiti Pralaya Sadhana Shakti Rita Chaiva Jasya Bhuvanani Vibhati Durga. Jasya hi Srishti Sthiti Pralaya Sadhana Shakti Rita Chaiva Jasya Bhuvanani Vibhati Durga. Icchanu Rupamapi Jasya Cha Cheshtate Sa Durga Jasya Icchanu Rupamapi Cheshtate. Not independent. As the Supreme Personality of Godhead desire, she was Govinda Madhipuru Santavam. So, description of this, Krishna has proposed in the beginning of this chapter that Asam Sam Samagrammam Jatha Gyasasi Tatshe. Without any doubt, as you can understand me completely, I am described. Now here is the description. Krishna said that the material energy and the spiritual energy, both of them are different energies of Krishna. In the Vedas also it is stated पराशक्ति विविधैव श्रियते न तस्य कार्यं तरणांश विद्यते न तस्य समा अधिकस्य दृश्यते पराशक्ति विविधैव श्रियते तावाम विज्ञान बल क्रिया च The Supreme Personality of Godhead has nothing to do himself because his energies are so complete that simply by his desire the energies work sabhavita, automatically. Just like the energy within a seed, you implant it, put it within the earth, put little water and it fructifies, it becomes a big tree, banyan tree. The energy is so perfect. We can study by ordinary understanding. The banyan tree, one fruit, and there are thousands of seeds within one fruit. And each seed is containing another banyan tree. This is a fact you can experience, that how much energy is there, a small seed, but the energy is so complete that it can produce a big banyan tree. Not only big banyan tree, many millions of fruit, fig fruit, and each and every fruit, there are millions of seeds. Just imagine. Parashakti, the energy of the Supreme, how perfect it is. And so perfect, sabhaviti jnana balakriya. The energy is put there, electric energy or spiritual energy is there, and automatically it becomes perfectly there, wherever it is, as it is required. Sabhaviti jnana balakriya. We try to paint one picture of banyan tree. It will take so much energy of us, and then still it is simply painting. It is not perfect. But Krishna's energy is so perfect that within the seed everything is there. And in due course of time, it fructifies and comes into nice perfect tree. This is called Krishna's energy. Both the spiritual energy and material energy, the source is Krishna. Therefore the conclusion should be that life does not come from matter. Matter comes from life, as it is said in the Bhagavad Gita. Vinna prakriti me astadha. Krishna is life. And from him this material energy, earth, water, air, fire, ether, mind, intelligence, and false ego has come. So he huge, gigantic, material, cosmic manifestation is caused by the Supreme Life, not that life has come from matter. So there are so many theories, but Krishna, the Supreme Life, the Supreme Being, is the source of everything. Therefore Krishna says, Aham sarvasya prabhava matta sarvam pravartati. This fact is known to the devotee. Vasudeva sarvam iti sa mahatma sudhirbhava. Krishna is the source. Absolute truth is Krishna. In the Vedanta Sutra, the inquiry is Athāta Brahma Jignyāsa, who said, what is that absolute truth? The supreme source of everything. The supreme source is Krishna. That is explained in the Śrīmad-Bhāgavatam. In the beginning, जन्मादस्यतः अन्नयात इतरतश्च अर्थेषु अभिज्ञा सरा अभिज्ञा कृष्णा इज द सुप्रीम क्रिएटर एंड ही नोज एवरीथिंग अन्नया व्यतिरेकेन डायरेक्टली एंड इनडायरेक्टली बोथ वे ही नोज एवरीथिंग ही सेज ऑल थिंग्स भगवद गीता वेदाहम समितीतानि He knows everything. Krishna, when he was asked by Arjuna that you say that this philosophy of Bhagavad Gita was taught by you to the sun god, how can I believe it? The answer was that the thing is that both of us, we are present. That you have forgotten, I have not forgotten. That is the difference between Krishna and ordinary living. He is complete. We are not complete. We are incomplete, fragmental portion of Krishna. Therefore, we must be controlled by Krishna. If we do not agree to be controlled by Krishna, then we shall be controlled by the material energy, this bhumi rapa analoga. Actually, we are spiritual energy. We should voluntarily agree to be controlled by Krishna. That is devotional service. That is devotional service. We are spiritual energy and Krishna is the Supreme Spirit. So if we agree to be controlled by Krishna, then you are promoted to the spiritual world. If you agree, Krishna does not interfere with your little independence. Jatekshasi tathapur. Krishna says to Arjuna, whatever you like you can do. That independence we have got. So out of that independence we have come to this material world. To enjoy freely. So Krishna has given us freedom. You can enjoy freely. And we are trying to do that. But the result is that we are becoming entangled. We are given the freedom to work in this material world. Everyone is trying to become the master of the material world. Nobody is trying to become the servant. Only we, the Vaishnavas, we are trying to be concerned. The Kurmis and Gyanis, they do not like to become servants. They criticize us that you Vaishnavas, you have got slave mentality. Yes, we have got the slave. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come. Gopi Bhaktu Padakamalayo Dasa Dasa Dasanu Dasa. That is our position. What is the use of claiming artificially, I am master? If I have been master, then why the fan is required? I am servant of this influence of summer season. Similarly, I shall be servant in the winter season. Too much cold. So we are all a servant. Therefore Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, Jive Sarupaya Nitya Krishna Das. Actual our constitutional position is eternal servant of Krishna. Krishna is the supreme consciousness. This Krishna consciousness movement is meant for this purpose that these foolish persons or asking, Murha. I am not manifesting the word foolish in that sense. It is said by Krishna. Namana Dushkitanam Murha Prapadante Narahama. He has spoken like that. He'll find. Dushkitanam always acting sinfully. And Murha and asking as Narahama, lowest of the mankind. Oh, you are Krishna, you are speaking so much ill of this materialist scientist, there are so many philosophers, they are all Narahama. Yes, they are Narahama. But they are educated, yes, that is also, but what kind of education? Maya apurita jnana. The result of their education, knowledge has been taken away by Maya. The more one is educated, the more one is atheist. At the present, of course, education does not mean. Education means to understand, jnani. Educated means wise man, educated man, jnani. The actual jnani means mam prabhadvante. Maunam janmanamanti janvan mam prabhadvante. That is education. Education does not mean to become a thief. There is no God, I am God, you are God, everyone is God. This is not education. This is ajnana. The Mayavadis, they think that they have become one with God. That is not education. That is, describing the Srimad Bhagavatam, Janneru Vindakha Vimukta Mani. They are thinking that they have become liberated. But actually, Avishuddha Buddha, their intelligence is not purified. Therefore, falsely claiming, he, one is God, and how he has become God. This much common sense there is. God is God, dog is God. This Dattavad philosophy is perfect. Atinta Vedal, simultaneously one and different. We have God. Because you have spiritual energy, therefore Krishna is Supreme Spirit. Therefore, we are one in quality, but Krishna is the Supreme. Ano Aniyam Mahato, who is Mahato Mahiya, and we are Ano Aniya. We are smaller than the smallest. This relationship with Krishna is perfect. If we had been actually God, then why we are fallen? This is not possible. God is God. He is never, God's name is Achyuta. He never falls down. But living entities, they are Achyuta. They fall down from the spiritual platform to the material platform. So they may, although we are fallen in the material platform, but because we are spiritual energy, therefore Krishna is describing the living entity as para-prakriti. It is prakriti. Prakriti means to be controlled by the Purusha. This is to be understood. Prakriti is never controlled. The Purusha is controlled. Therefore Krishna says, aparayam itastri vidhime prakritim para. So, jiva bhutan mahavayo jayadam dhajate jagat. It is para-prakriti, superior energy, because it is trying to control over the material energy. Every one of us, we are trying to control over the material energy. The big stone, big hill, that is material energy, but the spiritual energy, a human being, is breaking the hill by dynamite. Therefore it is superior energy. It is also energy, but superior energy because it can control even the biggest mountain. Nowadays, by scientific advancement, they are making so many tunnels within the big, big mountains. Big, big ocean, they are making tunnels. that drilling oil controls, therefore superior. But that does not mean they have become God. That is mistake. God is different. God is Krishna, the supreme controller. He is controller of the material energy and the superior energy. This should be the conclusion. Jiva Hutam Mahabhava Jaidam Bhagati. Because that will be explained in the next verse, because the superior energy is controlling the material energy, or trying to, not controlling, but trying to control. That is called struggle for existence. Actually, we cannot control the material energy, but we are trying, that endeavor to try to control over this material energy is called struggle for existence. Actually, we shall not be controlled. We shall not be able to control. That is explained. Therefore, in the material world, we are trying to solve one problem, but we are getting new problems. In the Western countries, we see it very easily. Man manufactures the horseless carriage, motor car, to go very swiftly. But now his problem is where to park and how to drive the motor car. In America, you have seen, they are increasing different parts, one upon another. You see, the problem is not solved. You still somewhere you'll find bottleneck, so many accident. So we cannot actually solve the material problem. That is not possible. Material energy is so strong. You cannot control it. Because real controller is Krishna. We are simply trying to control over the material energy, that we will never be successful. This is knowledge. Krishna says, therefore, Momo Maya Guruttaya. It is very difficult. Without Krishna consciousness, forgetting Krishna, we are trying to control over the material energy. That is explained by Vaishnava poets, very simple language. Krishna bhuliya jeev bhogavan chapare pasete mayakare japotiya dhare. As soon as we forget Krishna, the supreme controller, and we want to control over the material energy, bhogavan chapare. Bhoga means control. I shall control this market. I shall be the head of the market. Everyone is trying. So Krishna bhuliya. He does not know the real controller is Krishna. So Krishna bhuliya ji bhogavansha pare. This bhogavansha, on account of this bhogavansha, he becomes subjected to the condition offered by this material nature. Therefore it is said, Devidhi sadhanami mumma maya durutya māmeva japrapadvanti māyāme kāntaram. So in the Bhagavad Gita, everything is explained. Either you study comparing with the modern scientific and philosophical way, or as you accept it, as it is, the conclusion is the same. Krishna is the supreme controller. That will be explained later. The best thing is, if we become wise, wise means, Krishna says, if this is your position, you have to surrender unto me. You did not surrender unto me, therefore you are suffering so much in this material world. Today is Krishna's birthday. He descends to give us instruction. Paritrana sadhana vinashaya cha dushkita. Krishna advanced himself. Yada yadai dharmasya jnani bhavati bharata. This is dharmasya jnani. What is that? When we forget Krishna and try to become the master of the world. This is dharmasya jnani. When you want to become master of Krishna, that is dharmasya jnani. We are requesting and training the bewildered living entity who has forgotten Krishna to revive Krishna consciousness so that he may be saved from the onslaught of material nature. This is Krishna consciousness moment. This is the greatest humanitarian welfare activity to the human society. Take it very seriously and be happy. Thank you very much.